a test to see what happens. I'm using a 50 millimeter lens on my Sony a6400, which is a crop sensor camera, which means it's really 75 millimeters, which means it's really hard to vlog with this lens because I am pretty far away. I can't really see what's going on. It's really bright. It's crazy out here, but it's beautiful. And I just wanted to stop real quick because this is on my mind and I want to talk about perseverance, okay? I just finished a film that took me 20 months to finish. 20 months, almost 2 years. It's like a true pandemic project. And I gave my whole life to this project. Like, I worked 24/7 crazy on this thing because, first of all, I had no idea what I was doing at the beginning. You know, I was like making a film, which I had never really even held a camera before, really. Like, not to the point where I knew how to deal with white balance and aperture and ISO and stuff like that. You know, I had used like those, you know, paper cameras that you could buy in a CVS or something like that, but I had never really used a camera, but I knew how to use my phone. So that's what I shot the film on. I shot it on a phone. And anyway, I put a lot of work into it. I wound up calling in some collaborators, so I involved other people, which means that I feel even more responsible about this thing now. I'm by a train station, so that's why you hear the train. So anyway, I'm kind of at a point now where I've finished, and this project has far exceeded my expectations. Like, it is so much more and better than what I expected it to be at the beginning. It was just like I had really just started to do it because I was supposed to open a new play in June of 2020 in New York City, and obviously it got canceled. I'm a theater artist, and I was incredibly depressed. Like, I mean, this was a big deal. It was at a big theater. It was one of the biggest things I had ever done. I'm a solo performer. It was a big solo play. It was just very depressing when it got canceled. And as time progressed and a couple of, you know, weeks went by and then a couple of months, it seemed like, oh my God, this is never gonna happen, you know? So I felt like, you know, rather than jump off a bridge, I just thought, you know, like, I'm gonna make a movie. And so I took my theatrical script and I started working with that. I hated everything that I was doing. So I wound up writing a proper screenplay, and I wrote a completely different story for this film. And came out good. You know, like, I really love it. I'm very proud of it. I am incredibly proud of the music on it, the collaborators that I had, songs and a score. And it's a pretty remarkable project, I have to say. It's pretty cool. But now it's done, and I'm like, I don't even know what to do with it now. You know, like, I'm gonna submit to festivals and things like that, but, you know, I learned recently that I don't even know the proper formatting for festivals. You know, there's like, I spoke to a theater down in Asbury Park, New Jersey, because I was gonna do a screening down there, and the manager asked me if I had DCP. And I'm like, I don't do that. You know, like, I don't smoke weed or anything like that. And he started laughing. I was like, what are you talking about? He goes, DCP is a film format for theater. Like, if you don't have DCP, I can't screen the film here. And I'm like, well, I have an MP4, I can make a quick time. He's like, I need DCP. And then I researched it, and DCP can cost like thousands of dollars. And so, I don't know, I guess it's like mastering an album, something like that. But it's just yet another thing that I have to figure out and then try to kind of come up with a way to get it done if I want to participate in festivals that only accept DCP. And you know, there's a lot of other stuff that I have to deal with, you know? And so that's the thing I'm talking about as far as perseverance. You know, it's like, it takes a lot of perseverance to, first of all, actually come up with an idea to start a project. Like, you know, I wrote a play. I mean, I'm a playwright. I've been doing this for a long time. So I understand what the perseverance is to come up with an idea. Like, you know, anybody can come up with an idea, but then you have to like sit down and actually put it on paper or on your computer or whatever is your medium for writing. And then you have to like work it, you know, and you have to, you know, kind of hopefully bounce it off of other people and workshop it. And it's a long process. Sometimes it could take years to get something up on its feet, you know, with regards to theater. And you know, I learned it's the same thing with film. It could take a year or 2 years to actually get something done. You know, and it takes a lot of perseverance. You have to do a lot of stuff that you don't like and that you wind up not keeping, and you just keep doing it and keep doing it until finally you find some stuff that you love, and then you try to build upon that until you have an entire project. And in my case, wind up being a feature-length film over 2 hours long. And it took a lot. It took everything out of me. You know, it took everything of me to get this thing done. You know, to figure out, you know, like I had to perform in a completely different way. It was not like theater where I have to project all the time and, you know, do things kind of, it's like hard. I mean, I've learned how to be intimate on stage in the theater, but I mean, it's like a whole nother level on screen, you know, when you're filming. So I had to learn like a whole new way of expressing myself in terms of performance. And of course, I also filmed the whole thing by myself. So I had to worry about all the technical stuff, the framing. I had to make sure that everything was, you know, properly, you know, balanced and exposed. And it was just crazy. You know, I had to learn about filters. And so I'm filming, I had to worry about the sound. You know, I'm filming to a separate device, you know, like I'm doing right now. So I had to get a lavalier mic. I had to learn about that. And you know, I've used lavalier mics in, you know, in the music business, but it was completely different when it comes to film. And so I'm like finding locations, I'm finding places where I'm not gonna get my shit stolen while I'm filming, because I'm out in the streets. And then I have to like get into the head of being in character and doing this stuff well. You know, you can't just like say the words, you have to do it well. And so it's a lot to think about. So it's an incredible amount of concentration and preparation before you actually get out there and shoot and record. It's a lot of alone time at home, and it's just a lot of perseverance. It's a lot of commitment. And now I have to honor this work, and I have to do something with it. And I'm not quite sure what I'm gonna do yet, because I don't even know this realm of sharing of art. You know, it's like I know how to share theater. You know, I know that I go to a theater and I get to be hopefully a part of somebody's season, or I can produce it myself and I'll just rent a space and get my collaborators and get a stage manager and a sound person, a lighting person, and I know how to do that. But with film, it's like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? You know, I'm not Steven Spielberg, I'm not Spike Lee. I can't just like put it on Netflix or put it on HBO. Like, I'm trying to figure out what to do. How do I get to these festivals? What are the right festivals, you know? I didn't realize that these festivals cost quite a bit of money just to submit, you know? And so I gotta figure that out. I have to figure out the correct path. And I wanna honor the work of my collaborators by doing this well and doing it properly. And so it is a tremendous amount of commitment and perseverance again now. You know, after I finished everything else, now I'm kind of starting all over again. And that's okay, because that's what I do. And that's what my life is based on, you know? Perseverance, commitment, dedication, you know, focus, and just promises to yourself. You know, I promise myself every day I'm gonna do the best that I can. I'm gonna try as hard as I can. I'm gonna learn as much as I can. I'm gonna try to stay as open as possible to do the best that I can. And in this case, it's not just for me, it's for some collaborators too. And even in the theater, you know, I usually have a director, I have people working with me, I have a theater that I'm responsible for to get people into the seats. And so perseverance is a thing. You know, whether it's with your nutrition, your training, your life, your relationships, with everything, your job, commitment, dedication, perseverance. You have to wake up every day and do it all over again. You have to persevere. You have to commit to doing the best that you could possibly do today. It's not enough that you did it yesterday. It's not enough that I did it for the last 20 months. It's not enough. Now, it's starting over again. What am I gonna do? Where am I gonna go? I recently asked a friend of mine to help me with a screening. But I realized that's a lot to ask of somebody, because you have to get a space. It's New York City, it's a big deal. It's not just like, hey, can you help me do a little project? It's like, the more people I engage, the more responsible I am. But you know, fortunately for me, I'm used to being responsible to myself. And I try to never let myself down. And I certainly don't want to let anybody else down. And so, yeah, you got to get on that train and you got to ride every day, you know? have to have a destination. You got to figure out what's the best destination. Where are you going to go? And you have to figure out how to make the journey as meaningful as possible. Get the most out of it, so that when you get to your destination, you can build upon that and keep going to another destination, another one and another one, and you just keep doing it. But I think the most important part of this is you have to be present in the moment. And so that's what I was thinking about today. You know, like, perseverance is about being willing to be as strong in your focus and your commitment in every single second of every day as you are with your long-term vision. You know what I mean? It's like anybody can have this big vision of where they want to go and what they want to do. But what are you going to do today to get you to the next place, to get you to the next minute, the next hour, the next day, the next month, the next year? You know, I've worked on plays for 6 years. You know, I've worked on projects for years. And then one day they end. And then I have to start another project. And I have to kind of get it up to do it all over again with a completely new story, a completely new path, a new journey, something that's completely different. And so you use what you learn, you gain all this knowledge, you become more experienced, and hopefully that helps you with each project, and you just kind of raise the bar a little bit and get a little bit better each time, hopefully. So anyway, that's all I wanted to share today. I think perseverance is like probably the most important tool you could use, certainly as a creator and as an artist, but I think also probably in life in general, you know? I mean, I'm still learning how to do that in many aspects of my life. I've certainly failed in many aspects, but I've also done really well in many other aspects of my life. And there are a lot of things that I'm proud of. A lot of things that I wish I could have done better, but I actually took a lot from those experiences and it helped me when I got to new things. So anyway, I'm gonna stop there. Thanks so much for watching. I just stopped, I'm in Croton on the Hudson in New York right now. I know that I can come to this train station and just set up this tripod. Nobody's gonna bother me here. So I like coming here every once in a while when I'm driving around. And it's also beautiful, as you can see. So I hope you're having a good day wherever you are. I hope you're well. Hope everybody you love is well. And let's continue to persevere as a society when it comes to everything. Recycling, the environment. Let's be kind to one another. Let's try to get this shit back together, because the world is crazy town right now. And that's a whole nother story. So that's it. Thanks again. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.